Hello and welcome to Yoga and Fitness. My name is Natasha and for the next 35 minutes I will be your guide. Please come into child's pose at the back of your yoga mat, forehead to the ground and eyes closed. Begin to lengthen and deepen the breath. This is going to be a restorative yin yoga practice, so we're going to be holding postures for far longer, going deeper, and overall moving much more slowly so that we can really get into the body and allow it to open up to us. We're going to begin the practice with some body waves moving through the spine as fluidly as water, warming up the body and preparing ourselves for deeper, longer postures. On the next inhalation, begin to roll out of your child's pose, coming into upward facing dog. Move slowly and with control, creating as much movement through that spine as you can manage. Continue moving through one round of breath here and use that exhalation to push yourself back, rolling through the spine and coming into your child's pose. Now let's do that three more times, moving in direct connection to your in and exhalation. For your reference, to inhale is to expand and to exhale is to contract. Try to keep that body breath connection through all that you do in your yoga practice. One more time, inhale as you unravel the body, coming forward and opening into upward facing dog. And as you exhale to push back, curl those toes around. We're going to transition now from a down dog to high plank wave-like variation. So let's push back into our down dog, keep those knees bent and roll yourself out to high plank. Continue to move through your body rolls. Down dog to high plank. Exhale as you push back into those hips, down dog. And inhale as you roll out and up into high plank. One final time, let's push out to high plank. And as you exhale, pushing yourself into those hips, coming into downward facing dog, pause here and bring those heels down. Relax your neck and release any tension you may be holding in your jawline or face. Let's all take a deep breath in together. And let's use that exhale, lift the heels and bring them both across to the right side. You should feel a deep and satisfying stretch through the left side of your body here. On the next inhale, lift your heels up and drop them across to the left side. Same stretch, other side. And now let's bring those heels back to center and draw them down to the ground. Inhale, left leg lifts to three-legged dog. Exhale, leading with that left knee, bring your knee up and in between your hands. Let's move into a pigeon pose. Taking a moment just to get our bodies into correct alignment. And now let's inhale, filling our lungs on an arm extension, look forward. And as you exhale, slowly come down into a forward fold, resting your head on your hands. Close your eyes. And allow yourself to drift on the rhythm of your breathing as your chest rises and falls. Now let's all take a collective inhalation. Let's fill our lungs. And on the exhale, bring those hands beneath the shoulders and extend your arms, coming back to a seated position, pressing the torso back and releasing your pigeon pose. Now let's transition to a full leg extension. So extend both legs out at the hip and face the length side of your yoga mat. Inhale as you lift your arms up and connect your palms above the head. Move straight into a side body stretch to the left side, using your core for balance and strength. Now come up and across to the other side. Inhale yourself back to center and take that exhale and forward fold, moving down and forward, resting your forehead on your hands. Again, closing your eyes, pointing your toes upward towards the ceiling and trying your best to get as relaxed in this position as possible. Don't worry about how far forward you can come here. It's okay if you cannot touch the floor and double over. That will come in time and with regular practice. Even if you can only come an inch or two forward, please just try to protect the integrity of your spine. So don't hunch forward, keep it nice and straight, and just allow the body weight to bring you slowly forward. Also incorporating the breath into that, using each exhale as a chance to go a little deeper. Let's all take a collective inhalation together. And using that exhale, slowly bring your palms beneath your shoulders and extend your arms, pushing yourself back up to a seated position. Bring the soles of your feet together in front of you, taking a butterfly pose. I'm just going to turn and face you now. When you feel ready and in position, just balance your weight through the sit bones by rocking from side to side. Inhale through the arms, bring your palms above your head. And as you exhale, extend your arms in front of you and move forward and down into a forward fold, resting your forehead on your hands, closing your eyes, and again, just allowing yourself to drift on that gentle rhythm of your breathing. Let's all take a deep breath in together. And as you exhale, bring your hands beneath your shoulder blades and extend your arms, pushing yourself back up to a seated position. We're going to move into pigeon on the other side. So leave your right knee where it is. Extend your left leg behind you. Open up through the chest. Inhale. And exhale, slowly coming forward, moving into your forward fold and resting your forehead on your hands. Again, closing your eyes. Let's all take a final deep breath in together. And as we exhale, extend your arms, push yourself back. Bring that right leg back behind you, move to high plank. Slowly drop your knees down. Open up through the knees. And we're going to come into a wide-legged child's pose. So push back into those hips and rest your forehead down on the ground, extending through the upper body forward. If you're happy here, please stay. And if you would like to go a little deeper, then let's move into puppy pose together. Knees under hips and extend forward through the upper body, dropping the chest down. Keep your forehead tucked under for a little bit more of a gentle stretch, but bring your chin to the ground like I am doing for a deeper stretch. One more deep breath in, all together. And as you exhale, push into those hands, lift yourself up, bring those elbows down and drop the hips down. Look forward. Moving into Sphinx pose, shoulders back, chest lifted. Let's all take one more deep breath in here. And as we exhale, release, lowering your head towards the ground and pushing back into those hips as you lift your body up and move into a high plank. Lift your left leg up and place it on the outer left side of your yoga mat. Moving into lizard pose. I'm going to offer you a couple of variations depending on the intensity level that you wish to have today, and I'll let you guys just choose what feels best for you. Stay here with this full leg extension if you wish, or drop that right knee down and come a little lower through the legs. Stay here if this feels comfortable for you, or to go a little deeper, you can actually bring your elbows down and drop the forehead towards the ground. If you're looking for a visual reference to what I meant, I'm going to bring my elbows down now. Let's all take a deep breath in together now. And using that exhale, bring those hands down and extend yourself backwards. Moving back into those hips and extending that left leg, coming forward and down into half split pose. Take a book or a block and place it under your left glute muscle for a bit of added support in this pose. Inhale through the arms, keep that left leg strong and extended, left toes up towards the ceiling and forward fold on the exhale. Release your neck here and incorporate the weight of your head into this stretch. Be mindful of any tension you may be holding in the jawline or face and try to release that with your exhale. I recommend just closing your eyes here. And going inward, focusing on your breathing. Let's all take one more deep breath in together. And using that exhalation, bring your hands down by your side, extending your arms and lifting yourself back into a seated position. Moving slowly. Release your book or block. Bring your left leg bent underneath you and let's just sit on our heels for a moment. Inhale through the arms. Bring them above your head and connect your palms. Take a micro back bend, engaging your core. Drop the head and neck. And as you bring your hands to heart, inhale. Open the arms again to the side. And as you exhale, bring the arms together, left under right, and eagle wrap through the arms. We're going to move through a couple of body rolls here. As you exhale, drop the head and neck back, engage the core, and take a micro back bend. As you inhale, roll the body forward and drop the forehead down. Repeat this 3 more times. One more time. Let's come back up. Open through the arms. Inhale deeply. Extend through the arms. Inhale. And as you exhale, take a cactus arms, drawing those elbows down. Inhale, extend. Exhale, eagle wrap through the arms on the other side. This time bringing the right arm under the left. Wrapping at the elbow and connecting at the wrist. Let's all take a deep breath in together. And as we exhale, drop the head and neck back, engage the core, and let's move through some more of those body rolls. And inhale as you slowly roll yourself forward. Exhale, come back. Inhale, come forward. Let's take one more body roll. And as we bring ourselves back up onto our heels, neutralize the spine and inhale, the arms open and extended above head. Exhale, cactus arms, draw those elbows down. Inhale, extend through the arms. And exhale, bring your hands up to the top and to the left side of the yoga mat. Bring your right foot up to the right side of the yoga mat. Let's come back into lizard. Again, choosing the variation of lizard that feels good for you today. Full extension, or you can bring that knee down anytime you wish. I'm going to now bring my left knee down. It was at this point that I also brought my elbows down, relaxing my neck and allowing the weight of my head to come down towards my hands. Don't forget to use the power of your breath to get through this pose. Deep, slow breathing, releasing tension or discomfort on every exhale. Let's all take one deep breath in together before we prepare to move on the exhalation, coming back into our half-split pose, pushing back into the left hip whilst you simultaneously extend the right leg. Now place that block or book beneath your right glute muscle, getting yourself nice and comfortable in your half-split pose. When you're ready, inhale as you lift your arms open and bring your palms above the head. Use that exhale to come forward down into your forward fold. Release your neck here and allow the weight of your head to be incorporated into this stretch. Bring your focus to your breathing. Deep, slow breath. Filling and emptying your lungs with every in and exhalation. Let's all take a deep breath in together. Using that exhale, bring the palms beneath your shoulders. And as you extend your arms, draw those shoulders back and come back to a seated position. Remove your block or book. Bend that right leg behind you. And let's begin to move ourselves into a tabletop foundation. And let's take a round of cat-cows here. So we inhale as we drop the belly, look forward, chest lifted, shoulders back. And we exhale as we lift the spine, relax the neck and drop the head. Keep that cycle going, moving to the rhythm of your own breath. One more time to cat, exhale. And as you inhale to neutralize the spine, also lift the right arm up and follow with your gaze, stacking your shoulders. As you exhale, thread that right arm under your left, extending your left arm up towards the front of the yoga mat. You can follow the right hand with your gaze. Settle into this posture. Allow your body weight to be incorporated. You should be feeling a deep stretch through the right shoulder. Make any adjustments needed to be comfortable. Close your eyes and let's just focus inward on our breath. One more deep breath in together. And using that exhale, draw your left hand under your left shoulder, extending that arm and lifting your body out. Now extend that right arm up and bring it back down under your right shoulder, back to tabletop, and moving straight into a couple of rounds of cat-cow. Inhale, drop the belly, look forward to cow. And exhale, lift the spine, drop the neck to cat. Keep this going. Now neutralize the spine. Inhale as you lift your left arm up towards the ceiling, stacking your shoulders. And exhale as you thread that left arm under your right shoulder. Again, extending your right arm up towards the front of the yoga mat and following that left hand with your gaze. Try to settle in, get comfortable, close your eyes, and just feel the gentle rise and fall of your chest with every in and exhalation. Let's all take a deep breath in together here. Using that exhale, draw that right hand underneath the shoulder, extending that arm and lifting your body out of this pose. Bring that left arm one more time up towards the ceiling, follow with your gaze, and bring that hand back down to tabletop foundation. Let's take a couple more body rolls here, pushing back into those hips and rolling through the spine, coming forward. Keep this movement going and match the movement to the breathing. And now let's push back into a child's pose with our knees together. Drop that forehead down to the mat. Close your eyes. And again, allow yourself to drift on the rhythm of your breath. Filling and emptying your lungs with every in and exhalation. Rest here and allow all the work that you have just put into the last 35 minutes to be integrated on a cellular level through the body. press pause and hang out here if necessary. If you wish to close the class off with me, let's come back up onto our heels. Thank you so much for joining me. It is such a great honor that you choose to practice yoga with me. If you enjoy my classes and wish to show your support to the channel, there is going to be a link below where you can buy me a coffee. Any and all donations are hugely appreciated. Another way to really help the channel out is to just simply subscribe. Leave a comment, request a video, and hit that bell notification so that you don't miss any future classes. I release 2 classes a week, one on Friday and another on Sunday. I wish you a beautiful day. All the absolute best to you. Namaste.